In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of Firebase in-app messaging in your Flutter application. So what is an in-app messaging and how is it useful for us in Flutter application? So for suppose you have implemented some new services, or just consider you have got some new offers in your application and you want to improve the user engagement in your application so that they can get to know all these new offers which you have added recently, then you can just trigger an in-app message so that the users will get to know the latest offers. So in the in-app message will appear just like an alert dialog in your application. So there you can just show an image and add dynamic buttons so that the users can tap on the buttons and move to the respective screens, or also you can just navigate them to external websites. And you can also make use of deep linking concept. So we have previously dealt with the Firebase deep linking concept, push notification concept and remote configuration concept. So we have covered all these things in our previous tutorials, and I will be providing the link in the description section also. You can just go through them and you can just link them with this current tutorial also and make the users know about the services offered in your application much easier than before. So in this part of the tutorial, we will go with the concept overview first. And so it involves a very less coding in your Flutter application, but more about your Firebase console. So we'll just configure our Firebase console to push a in-app message to your Flutter application. That's it. And that is what we cover in this particular tutorial. And in the coming tutorials, we'll be seeing more about in-app messaging concept in detail. So now let's get started by adding the dependency first. So let's go to the terminal and start typing flutter pub add firebase core. So firebase core is our library which we need to add to our project. So here now we have just added it to our pub spec file here. So here you can see firebase core, and the latest version is been added here. So this is the advantage of making use of the terminal here. When you don't know the latest version, you can just Google it and add it. But you know, from the terminal, you can just directly add the library by specifying its name. It will be the latest version will be added to your project. So yes, now let's get started with the coding. And also you need to add class path here in the build Gradle. So here when you open the Android directory here, so within the build.gradle file, so this is the root level build.gradle file, and here you need to add the Google services class path here, and within the root level app.build.gradle file here, you need to specify here Google services plugin. So these two things are mandatory, and if you have not specified this, you may not receive the in-app messaging. So as I've said earlier, there is nothing much in the coding for this tutorial. So I'm just going a bit fast, material.tar, and within the void main. So in our previous tutorials also, we have seen the implementation for the Firebase services. So in the same way, widgets, flutter binding dot ensure initialized. And later we will be initializing Firebase dot initialize app. So here it has automatically imported the Firebase core here. So in the step here, in the sixth line here, we have imported. And now let's specify run app, and there let's specify our class myApp. And from here, it's the default coding which we almost do for every application. So now let's try to add in-app messaging to our application. So for that, let's type flutter pub add firebase in-app. So let's specify the exact spelling so that you should avoid these kinds of spelling mistakes. And now our package will be added to our project according to the latest version available. So here you can see the package is now been added. So this is what we have done for the coding here. So yes, this is a basic thing. We have just added a material app bar, body, everything. So now let's get started with the Firebase configuration. Today for triggering an in-app message, so let's copy this, and as this is the logo of our new website. So we have logged into our Firebase console, and here you can just add your application here by specifying the package name and the app name, and all these things we have covered mostly in all our previous tutorials, so I'm just providing the link for them. If you are having any queries, you can just refer them to know how to add the Android app to Firebase, or else you can just let me know in the comment section below. I will surely try to help you. So here, this is an option, in-app messaging. So when you tap on this for the first time, you will be getting a button like get started. So when you tap on this, you will be getting this particular button like new campaign or new experiment. And now, so let's here try let's to go with a new campaign here, and here you can see I have already created a new campaign here, so I will be just making use of this. So let's try to see what I have done here. So this is a model here, and the model appear like this. So there is only the design change and nothing much more. So just try with our card here, and we are going to specify our image, and here I'm going to just edit the body here. And these are all the other options you can add. So we have just add the portrait image here, and also you can just append the landscape image if you want to. And they have also specified the aspect ratios here. So you can just follow them to make a good and clean look. And here they are also asking for the primary button here. So this is a primary button which will be by default available. So I'm just going to rename it like visit website. And here is the text color and the button action. So by default it's like dismiss as the action. So in our general alert box also we have an option like dismiss for the cancel button. So it's just like that we have here. So in the similar way we have dismiss here for as a default action when you tap on the button here. So we don't want that, we just want to redirect to our website here. So copy this URL and paste it over here, or you can just redirect within your application also by making use of the dynamic links. So here in this particular tutorial we have discussed about the Firebase dynamic links, so you can just go through them and try to use it here. And also you can add one more button here. So secondary button you can just add like cancel button I am going to add. So here you can see visit website, and the other one is cancel button. And for the cancel button we have dismiss as the action here. So here it has provided us two options, that is two buttons. So we have used the two buttons, and when you tap on the next here, it's asking the target here, campaign name. So you can just specify the campaign name. I'm going to specify it's like website and the campaign description. So it's an optional thing, and you can just add it according to your requirement. And eligible users, so here you can select the eligibility here. So these are all my different projects here. So this is the package name for our current project, so I am selecting this one because in my current Firebase project I have 5 different apps. So I am just going to select our current app, and here it's asking few more requirements here like version. So which version of the app you are going to target. For example, you have the new services in the latest version, so you can just target that particular version only, and the message will only be sent to the users who have installed that particular version which you are targeting. And here the languages. So based on the languages also you can just differentiate, and country, region, audience. So all these things you can just add it according to your requirement. And currently I don't have any requirements, so I'm just leaving it as default. And also here it's providing us an option to localize your message. So what is localizing the message is like whenever you try to send any message, so you can just convert it into different languages depending upon your users. So English and different languages, you can just convert your text message, and can that particular message will be appeared onto your alert dialog. So here in our first step we have seen, right? So this particular message we can just convert it into the different languages. So that particular option is this. So currently I just want it to be in the English only. And the next step is scheduling. So when you want to send this particular message, you can just schedule it, for example like midnight, 12 o'clock, or at the time of your offer release. So you can just schedule it accordingly, but I just want it to be sent now. And here end date, by which date you want to stop the sending of the message. For example, you are having the offer for 5 days, and from today till 5 days you can just set a target. And here you can also send once per device for this. So for this particular campaign you want to send the message for all the users only once. So here you can select that particular option here, or you want to send the message every day once per the user. So for example, each user for the complete 5 days will get the message 5 times. So here you can select that, and if you want to increase the interval you can just add it like this. So for the 5 days campaign you just want to send the message only once. So here depending upon this you can just select the thing. So I'm just selecting display no more than one message every 1 day. And you can just add the events also based upon your requirement. So here the by default it is like on foreground. So whenever your application is on foreground, that is whenever your application is open, then we are going to send this particular in-app messaging. So here conversion events and all these are optional. And yes, if there is a requirement for you, you can just add it over here. So what are the conversion events like? So if you have any subscription in your application, or you just want to know the first open, any purchase, all these things if you want to track, you can just make it over here. And additional options. So here is the key value option which is available for us. So whenever the user taps on the particular button, so based on this custom data you can process further. For example, if there is any coupon code you want to provide to the user, so here you can just provide the coupon code and a value, key value here, and whenever the user taps on that particular button you can just apply the coupon code there. So this is just an example I'm saying. So like this way you can just add some things and just tap on the review here. So here you can see we have received our in-app messaging in our emulator here. So this is how we can send an in-app messaging to our Flutter application. So now let's try to tap on the visit button, so that it is asking us to open the website, and now our website is also being opened here. So yes, this is how simple you can just integrate in-app message in your Flutter application using Firebase. So yes, this is it for this tutorial on in-app messaging. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.